look rabbit.
Actually, it's pronounced Wabbit.
I don't think you know who you're messing with.
You're right, I don't. And you are?
I am the Vice President of the United States!
We still have one of those?
Yes.
Like this?
Yeah!
You better take cover, kid.
My name's Yosemite Sam.
What's up, dog?
This is Marc Morrell from ToonBarn, and we're here at New York Comic Con 2015, and we're talking about Wabbit, a Looney Tunes production. And I'm here with Bob Bergen, who does the voice of Porky Pig.
Yeah, that's right. Hi, Marc.
And J.P. Karliak, who does the voice of Wile, Coyote.
I'm slightly disdained to be here.
I'm sorry to hear that. All right, so I'll start with you, Bob.
All right.
We saw you on I Know That Voice.
Yes.
Okay. And
where I
you
taught everybody on the planet to take my job away from me. Yes.
Yeah. Showing the progression of doing the Porky Pig.
But it hasn't happened yet, so I think I'm still doing okay.
Okay. And how did it feel to be on that documentary about voice actors?
Oh, that was awesome. When you can be a part of something, we went to the big premiere, and I'm learning from my peers that we don't talk about our process. The word acting kept coming up over and over again. It is acting, but everybody thinks, oh, it's just doing funny voices. I'm honored to have been in that company because, you know, you hope to do someday what you love to do, and to be able to be a part of that ensemble documentary was pretty extraordinary.
Okay. And JP, Wile E. Coyote is a neighbor of Bugs Bunny in this round?
He is a neighbor. It's usually, the scenarios are usually Bugs is doing something mundane around the house or in the yard, and then Wile E. just interrupts and makes it all about the technological way to do it better.
So is he still a super genius?
Oh, super genius, who has studied at many prestigious online universities. Yeah,
he's great, but the thing that I love about this Wile E. is it's not about the hunger. It's not about, like, I need to eat, I need to catch this beastie for my next meal. It's just about his ego. It's just about feeding just, you know, his personality, which is a much larger appetite than his stomach could ever hold.
Okay. And is Acme still his store of choice?
Still the brand of choice, yeah, Acme brand only. Although now he purchases it all online.
That's right.
Oh, really?
Acme.com?
Yeah, there's a few episodes where he's on the computer ordering the neck, like a satellite dish or something.
Come by drone from Amazon?
there are a couple drones, actually.
Season 2, that sounds great.
There's a drone in one of the shorts, yeah.
Oh, that's cool. All right, could you give us a taste of one of his interactions with Bugs?
Let's see. One that I know we have coming up is... Oh, this one's a fun one. Wile E. does something that makes the power grid go out. And so he's forced to live without technology, and he's just completely has no ability to do it. And Bugs starts to teach him how to do things for himself. And just as he starts to get adjusted to it, that's, you know, the lights come back on. But
Wile E. wouldn't do well in an apocalypse, huh?
No. Or he'd be the cause of it.
Yeah, you're right. All right, so Bob, you also teach voice acting. Where can people go to learn more about that?
Well, I've got a Facebook page called All Things Bob Bergen, where I advertise, where I teach around the country. So I do weekend classes around the country. I do LA classes. At Bob Bergen on Twitter, please follow me. Facebook, just Bob Bergen. They can just pop me a note. If people have demos, they want me to critique them, I will. You know, just email them to me. Yeah.
Are Porky Pig and Bugs Bunny friends in this one?
Well, listen. Is Bugs friends with anybody? They're not friends, but they're not enemies. They're put into situations that cause conflict. So, they're just... I wouldn't call them friends. I would just call them...
colleagues.
Colleagues, there you go. Exactly, yeah, that's good.
So that's their relationship in this round of Wabbit?
You know, in this round, this version of these characters, they're put into weird situations. There's an episode where Porky Pig, it happens to be Bugs's, they call it his goober driver, and he tries to get him.
Now, did you say right? Did you say I take it? Am I going left?
And never gets him there on time, and it's hysterical. But it's taking these wonderful classic characters, putting them in contemporary situations, and making it work.
Right. We, when we talked to. Gary, it was about the technology and how it's, you know, grown into the 21st century for the cartoons now, and of course our characters are in it, and we don't mention the technology. We just they just interact like they normally would, like everybody else does. Yeah. So how does Wire League fit into everybody?
Well, I mean, as technology advances, he only gets happier.
That's right.
Wile is just very much the next door neighbor. I compare him to sort of like like Fraser Crane meets Kramer.
Oh.
You know, where he's always the unwelcome neighbor that just pops in uninvited. Right. But it's always with, you know, a smoking jacket, an extra panache, you know.
Thank you for explaining that. That makes complete sense to me, though. So I was wondering how they take him out of the desert and put him into a normal situation.
Well, oddly, he still lives in a stone cave that looks very much like something right out of you know the Death Valley scenes. But he even has a little Roadrunner bird bath that sits in the front yard.
Okay.
Yeah.
Does the Roadrunner ever show up?
Not yet.
Oh.
Yet.
Yet.
We're hoping.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So, which character would you like Porky Pig to work with the most?
Oh, on this show or just in general?
On this show.
Actually, I think a wily Porky would be hysterical because you'd be just like, get it out. What do you need?
Oh, yeah. Oh, what if I... yeah, I could be like a linguist or something like that.
That's right.
Yeah.
So do something. Let's do a little improv.
You know, what's the word?
Elocution. Here, let me put it on this device.
Why? The word is elocution. Oh, so I will talk like this from now on?
And then he can't get work, and then it becomes... yeah.
Exactly. Exactly. I'm going to talk like this now.
Brilliant. Awesome. It's like Ben Stein. Is
exactly. We've got to bring this idea to that producer.
Yes.
I like this.
Yes.
All right. Well,
thankfully, Gary knows who we are.
That's right.
We're glad we could be part of that creative process on ToonBarn. So thank you very much.
Brainstormed with you.
And we'll send you the residuals.
Okay. Thank you very much for joining us on ToonBarn, and enjoy the rest of Comic-Con.
Thank you. Thank
appreciate it.
Buddy, are you okay? You gotta take better care of yourself. You need a massage. I'm sure you remember these gentlemen, Knuckles, Spike, and Tiny. They'll be your masseuses today.
Are you for this, certified?
That's right. Align the spine. The rolling pin. Classic! Back and forth. Back and forth. Oh, I love tenderball. See, pal? Don't you feel nice and loose?
Like a hot sack of creamed corn.